coming up on top, and again, they both go with the drop kicks. What an aerial war. These are two run-and-shoot offenses like in the NFL. They're taking every chance they can, and the stakes are so high in this battle for the WCW World Light Heavyweight title in a match where you're looking at the only two men that have ever held that championship. Both men obviously very groggy here. He went for the power move. Waistlock, reverse, suplex with a bridge, belly to back. He's got, no he doesn't. Two and a half, I thought he had it. Liger now with Pillman, dazed, perhaps going for either a DDT. And Pillman countered. Pillman cross body, leg is hooked, one, two, and a, did he get it? Man, that was two and three quarters. Just a millimeter away. Pillman now must capitalize before Liger can regroup. Powerbomb! Powerbomb! And again! Did he go another two and a half? Maybe more. Liger thought he had him with that powerbomb. And quite frankly, so did I. Pillman counters. Oh, what a move. That was a page out of Scott Steiner's playbook, Modified Frankenstein. Knee lift, and the Irish whip to the center of the ropes on the far side, and a DDT. Liger at 212, Pillman at 223, and you have to wonder how much more their bodies can sustain of this high-impact punishment. Brian Bryan was a special team star for the Bengals. He's used to busting up those wedges on kickoffs, and that's exactly what it looked like there. Pillman again, a little groggy. He's right above us. And Liger takes the ropes, and Pillman comes down very uncomfortably. Again, Liger going for it all. Front face lock. Super pack. Sending shockwaves up his spine. That'll be all done. No, no, it's not. This kid from Cincinnati will not quit. Oh, Pillman moved. Liger hit his head on the canvas. Flying Brian using his legs, bridging back.